Hi guys, you're watching Just Wish and welcome to this new episode. I'm super excited about it because I'm in Namma, Bengaluru, and guess what? We are at the OG place for idlis, vadas and dosas. Meet my friend Rohan here.
Hi, what's up?
In this episode of Cuisines of Karnataka, we are walking the streets of Namma, Bengaluru and exploring some iconic breakfast institution. Watch us savor the softest of idlis and the crunchiest of vadas, some brilliant dosas, khara bath, kesari bath and an iconic chutney and the legendary South Indian filter coffee. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe button, ring the bell icon for all notifications and don't forget to follow me on Instagram for all the behind the scenes updates.
And Rohan, where are we?
So we are at Gandhi Bazaar and we are at this legendary place, breakfast place called Vidyarthi Bhavan.
Vidyarthi Bhavan, heard a lot about it.
Yeah, and it's a good place, I must say. Yeah, you can see the crowd and we hope to get into the place pretty soon.
Established in 1943, Vidyarthi Bhavan started out as a humble eatery catering to the students of the neighboring institutions. Walking into this pre-independence eatery is like stepping into Bangalore of the bygone era. Everything about this place exudes culinary heritage, from the picture frames to the hand-painted and rather limited menu board.
So we are finally in Vidyarthi Bhavan and it's already arriving, Rohan.
Yeah, man.
So what do we have?
So this is the khara bath or traditionally in our part of the country, we call it upma.
Okay.
And this is a sweeter version of the same thing, but it has pineapples and ghee. It's loaded with ghee, man.
Okay.
So this is kesari bath.
That's the first morsel of the day. And what a start. It's basically like a masala upma that we've had, if you guys have seen the Barampur video. But this is like a couple of notches above it. It's got a nice creamy aftertaste. This is basically made of suji or semolina and it's, they spiced it very nicely. You've got curry leaves.
Oh my
and God. As we speak, there you have it.
More food coming in.
Yeah. So now we have to go with the khara bath. We've got the other items coming in as well. So we've got idli, we've got
vada, we've got idli vada dip in sambar.
My God. I mean, the idli is so soft, like if you had to have anything softer than this, it would have been cotton.
Yeah.
You know, it doesn't get softer than
so
this.
It's like, you're saying it's like a savory version of the cotton candy?
Yeah, absolutely.
Only much better.
Yeah. And the thing is, if it was any softer than this, it would lose its ability to contain its shape. We'll quickly break into the vada. Now again, this is soaked in the sambar. The vada here is crunchy. I don't know how it's crunchy being soaked inside it. It's still crunchy, soft, and this is one of my personal favorites. Okay. And this is also made from suji. Let me try it first.
Wow. Can I take it?
No.
Thank you. Yeah. So, kesari bath, as you were saying, it's a dessert of sorts, but not exactly a dessert because you can have it as a whole breakfast in itself. Kesari, primarily because of the color, and it's a sweeter version of the khara bath that we had. It's got a lot of long, there's a very strong taste of, you know, long, or what do you call it, cardamom, and elaichi, right? So that, I mean, and it's loaded with ghee. Loaded with
the benne masala dosa is here. And what is benne?
Benne is butter.
Wow.
So coated with butter or roasted in butter and it's got masala inside.
Okay. So let's go ahead and open this. Oh my God. Okay, so this dosa is definitely crisp on the outside and it's soft and mushy on the inside.
Yeah.
It's visibly a slightly
pancake.
Thick, yeah. Slightly thicker.
Yeah.
And I know.
That's very typical of how dosas are made here or in this part of the country.
Okay.
You know, usually we are used to having dosa which is, you know, thin, crisp, very, you know, chip-like. But this dosa has got a lot of batter in it. And as you can see, it looks...
It's like benne everything, man. It's got a beautiful golden crust to it. The masala of the potatoes here inside, the aloo masala isn't spicy. What they've in fact done is that chutney is extremely extremely spicy that compensates for everything else, and it's got loaded with chilies, and that's in a good way that I'm saying.
Yeah.
That elevates the taste and takes it to a, you know, whole new level. I am so happy to have started the day with Vidyarthi Bhavan.
It's a good start to the day.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Absolutely mind-blowing. Mm. Okay, so the coffee is here. This is the quintessential South Indian filter coffee. And look at it, man. It's got this beautiful white froth right in the center. And
it's good to close your breakfast after you've had such a oily breakfast.
Yeah, wash it down.
Wash it down with a cup of coffee. And nothing like a filter coffee.
And you're supposed to pour it here.
Okay. It's too hot.
It's extremely hot.
Yeah, so I cool it down.
Aromatic coffee. Okay. Cheers. Cheers. Wow. In case you haven't woken up, this will definitely wake you up. The coffee just hits you. Like it
slaps you across the face.
It just hits you, right? Now, you're ready. You're a total Bangalorean. You've had your bende masala, dosa, idli, vada, sambar. Washed it down with a strong cup of hot coffee and ready to take on the Silicon Valley of India.
Yeah.
Now let's head to the next place and see what they have for. Chale?
Chalo.
This place is really good.
Now to push all the ghee down, we decided to walk to our next stop, which happened to be another celebrated culinary institution. Walking under the green foliage with cool breeze brushing against your face, man, there is nothing like Bengaluru.
So this is the iconic Brahmin's Coffee Bar, and we are here at Shankarpura. They have a very limited menu, about 4 to 5 items. You see the amount of people here, we've sent a friend inside to get something. And so once we get it, we'll go ahead and try. So welcome to Brahmin's Coffee Bar.
You wouldn't believe if I told you that this very place was started as a last resort by the late Mr. K.V. Nagesh Rao in 1960s. What is symbolic of Bangalore's identity today, this place used to be a garage. Talk about garage startups. Bangalore seems to have had them in the 60s as well.
So that is all that they have, right?
Yeah.
So you've got idli, vada, khara bhat. Kesari Bhat.
Kesari Bhat, yeah.
Wow.
You're doing the same thing again, but slightly different things.
Yeah. So this is the Khara Bhat, or like we said, the Masala Upma. Mm.
Is it different than what you had at Vidyarthi?
Yes, it is definitely different. It's got a little bit of a twang to it.
Mm.
Yeah. And I can definitely see a little more vegetables in this.
And less spicy? Different taste profile,
yeah,
and but it's good,
and both of them have like a beautiful creamy aftertaste. I can see kaju, and I think this is the everybody seed, isn't it? The seed inside is like an indigenous seed that you get here. So here you don't get the sambar served with the chutney
only.
Yeah,
there is no option of sambar.
There's no option of the sambar, and look at it, just about 4 or 5 items in the menu, and they've like perfected it. The idli is as soft as it could possibly get. Wow. And with the chutney, it has the green chili flavor. Here the chutney is not very spicy though.
Yeah.
Speaking of the chutney, in the language of the IT capital of India, they have a dedicated resource to dispense this delicious chutney. You see, double-hatting a sambar's role is not an easy task. Excuse my corporate lingo, but the chutney here is an outstanding performer.
Yeah, but the winner is the vada, man. Okay, so I'm gonna dig into the vada. Wow, yes, the vada is beautifully crisp from the outside, yet soft.
I really wonder how do they manage to make the vada that crisp, man. You can actually literally hear this sound. If you scrape it off, you can hear it break.
No wonder this place is so iconic. They've kind of maintained the recipe and kept it on for decades. The Kesari Bhat. Look at it, man, look at it.
Yeah, what a soft, that goes in, man.
Yeah.
Pure goodness.
Wow, the sweet flavor of the cashews, a very nice pineapple flavor. I'm in love with it. Well, Kesari Bhat again stands out, maybe because I have a sweet tooth for this.
So this is welcome to Namma Bengaluru, in the most epic possible way.
Nothing like Bengaluru.
Nothing like Bengaluru.
And you come to Brahmin's Coffee Bar and not have the coffee is blasphemy.
Yes, blasphemy, yes. Yeah. Cardinal sin. So again, very traditional Bangalore setup. And laid back, and then obviously You can seal your morning experience with a good cup of coffee. Nothing like it, right?
Mm. Absolutely. And the kind of weather that Bangalore has, so we miss mentioning that, just adds to the flavor.
Yeah.
And this coffee here is strong. Not very sweet. It's a slightly bitter side. But that's good. That's strong coffee. And I love coffee. And it's like a double whammy. Wow. And
so, if you noticed inside, they were filling up the coffee bit all the way till the half of the glass,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
The coffee was brewed in a copper pot, you know, adds to the flavor profile of the coffee, and then, you know, top it up with froth.
Yeah, and the way he was
frothing it up, right?
Wow.
That's skill. That's pure skill.
That's skill, and it's therapeutic to watch as well. So, hi, if you're new here, please hit the subscribe button that's there and share this video with your friends. Leave a comment below and let me know how this video felt. Also, if you've got time, there are more such videos there. You can go ahead and watch them. And well, I've also designed some merch themed on Karnataka, so you guys can check it out there. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.